They're going to be specced into that greater Pyroblast, that G-Pi, and they are going to be looking to sheep up Chun-Li, Orthogonomics, maybe get a ring on Goreki, and they're both going to be channeling out those, going to be casting, going to be baking those greater pies onto one of their targets. At the same time, the Druid is going to be trying to stunlock whoever they are casting those greater Pyroblasts on and go for basically big one-shots. I expect Chun-Li to be a very juicy target for them, but also Goreki.
Oh, Goreki running that Feral Affinity. I'm curious to see if Easy Money decide to go after him at all. Pressure onto Varen early on. Crowd control onto Tuna. This could be a Cauterize so early on. Bert trying to save the day. Polymorphs on Thugonomics managing. They actually get the Cauterize from Varen through the Iron Bark. That is not a good start for the Bakery whatsoever.
Yeah, definitely not ideal. We'll have to see what Bert and Varen can get done. Typically, Destruction Warlocks are really good into this composition. They have a lot of Destruction with Fear, with Spellock, with Mortal Coil, and Shadow Fury. So, single-handedly, he can shut down a lot of these greater Power Blasts, but as long as Thugonomics gets interrupted on Fear, he gets spam polymorphed, that's an opportunity for Bert and Varen to try to build up some damage. But I think Goreki, Chun-Li, and Thugonomics are relatively experienced
in
this matchup. One greater Power Blast, potentially a second, but Chun-Li's just going to respond. He's going to respect with the Touch of Karma, and I think it's likely he plays very defensive from this point forward. Fortifying Brew as he moves forward. Oh, I'm a little bit scared for Chun-Li right now. All he has is the Diffuse Magic. Goreki with no Iron Bark. Beautiful offensive Cyclone, but good damage here onto Bert. Might be able to get the Cauterize proc from him as well. Chun-Li forces out the Cauterize, and now both Vern and Bert are very exposed targets here, as none of them have that cheap death mechanic from the Fire Mage.
One greater Pyro. Varen preemptively temporal shielding on these Chaos Bolts. Another greater Pyro. Chun-Li is able to duck around the corner. It's basically, you need two of those from both mages at the same time to really be threatening. Currently, with the positioning Chun-Li has, he can escape to safety if he needs to, but he won't be able to if he's polymorphs. As we see Varen and Bert cooking up some double greater Pyros. Ursul's Vortex almost pulls them into a double stun if Chun-Li had waited just a moment longer. Thugonomics is trying to ramp up some damage, looking for crowd control, securing a fear, not onto the Restoration Druid, onto the mage, a little bit peculiar. These mages need to be careful. Without Cauterize, they can't rely on that to save themselves. They're going to have to predict the damage and ice block at a much safer margin. The pressure from the boys here is stellar. Thugonomics on that Destruction Warlock is devastating.
Yeah, definitely. Chaos Bolt's being cast out. Vern and Bert just looking for resets, and this composition is all about just destroying someone 100-0 very quickly. It's not necessarily about consistent damage. You're always looking for setups. That's why you see them throwing out polymorphs onto Chun-Li. Out of the polymorphs, that's when they try to go for the cast. But when you have Thugonomics backing you up, you have Goreki constantly going for these restealths, it becomes very difficult. Chun-Li now getting really aggressive with the Touch of Death and Maledict onto Bird. It does manage to redirect a lot of the damage, but still forced into the ice block. And I mean, for Easy Money, this is not looking good for them. They don't really have too many defensive cooldowns left to work with. The boys, they got some from Chun-Li, but now Touch of Karma is rotated back up. Diffuse Magic, Fortifying Brew. Chun-Li's going to be feeling healthy. Bert is not, as he's caught into a leg sweep. One Chaos Bolt lands. Thugonomics gets caught into a counterspell, into a polymorph, and now Bert looking for a greater Power Blast, but gets interrupted. And I have to say, the boys have been doing a great job so far, making sure they shut down a lot of the damage Easy Money has available.
Yeah, right now it's looking less and less like a bakery, or more and more like a bake sale. There's just been no pies cooked up by the team of Easy Money. They make a desperate swap to Goreki. This is what I was hoping to see them try and do with that Feral Affinity that can burst him down. He doesn't have access to Frenzied Regeneration. Varen blinks in, gets the greater Pyro, but Bert is being pressured away. He can't get in line of sight. He could easily fall as Tuna is feared off into the distance, now bashed up as Bert's likely to fall as the boys close it out here against the bakery. Temporal Shield's a couple seconds away for Bert, catching a quick heal, staying alive for now and staying in the fight. Tuna needs to try and look for a drink. Both these druids running Feral Affinity, looking for restealths, getting access to a free stun on their team. Definitely important to set up their caster, DPS, friends, the Destruction Warlock, and the Fire Mage. There's just been so much disruption on these greater Pyroblasts. We've never seen even more than just one casted at a time. Bert under fire. That Iron Bark needs to be enough for Bert to survive. Thugonomics goes all in. Unending Resolve to free cast Chaos Bolts. Really trying to end this right here and now. Trying to close down the shop, but not having enough damage to do so.
Yeah, double greater Pyroblast being channeled out by Bert and Vernon. And they only really need one good setup. Thugonomics gets
that punish.
A lot of incoming pressure. Goreki, how's he going to handle the situation? on any resolve was already used by Thugonomics aggressively, and now Karecki with no Iron Bark. Thugonomics is really vulnerable. Burt looking for another Greater Power Blast, gets stunned on it. Unfortunately, Thugonomics now retreating, and I think he should be fine. Baron gets one more off, but Thugonomics getting topped off. I think he's going to be fine. Now Touch of Death committed onto Burt. Burt struggling to survive. One Chaos Bolt connects. Polymorph spam coming in from Baron, trying to slow down the damage from the boys, but I just feel like Burt, he's in so much trouble with Tuna into a Fear. What is Burt going to do? He drops out the Ring of Frost, but Chun-Li all over him. Bash onto Tuna, and Easy Money gets shut down so easily in this matchup.
Really excited to Fire Mage can bring.
I mean, it certainly is an annoyance for sure. It's definitely, I would say, the best specialization to bring in a Warlock. Typically, when facing a Mage, if your main goal is to just make the Mage not get any of his potential burst off, if a well-played Warlock is going to be able to do that. So seeing Thugonomics shine here against Easy Money is definitely a nice treat. Will they be able to bake up some pies here in game number two? We're about to find out as Burt and Varen are sneaking around the outskirts of the map. They catch Karecki! Big catch here for Easy Money. Huge hits. Karecki manages to escape, but at the cost of basically his entire defensive lineup. He's still being pressured. Maybe they're just all in. I'd love to just see an all in on Karecki. Hunt him down, try and get him taken out very early on, but looks like he's able to recover. Now he's leading the charge for the boys.
Yeah, Burt in a lot of trouble here. Ironbark looking to deny, but Ice Block is forced out onto Burt. And sometimes as that Fire Mage, you really can't rely on the Cauterize, especially if the enemy team is using the Gladiator's Maledict on you. It will absorb that Cauterize heal. So it was good that Burt just decided to trade out that Ice Block for Cauterize, as it was likely he was going to just die through it. But he could just die anyways. Thugonomics still getting out huge pressure.
Here it is.
Karecki moving in. A lot of pressure.
Boom.
Chaos Bolt lands onto Varen, the wrong mage. I don't know if that was a misfire from Thugonomics, but I think that would have just killed Burt.
I think maybe Thugonomics thought Burt was going to be able to line of sight, so he tried to fake him out and go after him.
Oh, Chun-Li gets bashed! Multiple Greater Pyros coming!
Chun-Li defused magics, he's going to stay alive. Baron now on the back foot, Burt falling behind, Tuna really struggling. Karecki sneaks in a Cyclone, both mages in trouble. It is Danger Town for the Bakery. Chun-Li as well, though, is an exposed target. Is he just going to go all out for the kill? He might overextend and go down, caught in a Polymorph. This could be potential for Baron and Burt to set up. Double Greater Pyro, two in the oven. Tuna jumps in, they both connect. Chun-Li in tons of trouble as he gets bursted down, barely escaping to safety around the corner. Close call for Chun-Li.
Definitely health Stone from Thugonomics going to be paying off huge for Chun-Li in order to survive. And honestly, right now, the boys, they have a lot of pressure, but Chun-Li very vulnerable on this Windwalker Monk. This is definitely aggressive play here from them, and it can be punished by Easy Money. Luckily, in that first exchange, Karecki was in bear form when they opened up on him, so he's not going to get punished too hard. He didn't have to trade out his trinket. That means now that Burt and Vernon, they do once again have combustion available, Karecki still has his trinket, Barskin, Ironbark to work with, and that really is going to be the main threat from Easy Money. Big pressure on Varen once again. Tuna caught into the bash. Ice Block is forced out, and now both of these mages incredibly vulnerable.
Yeah, both these teams are just playing it up brutally. Just no signs of defense by either side, just all out trying to go for kills. We haven't seen playstyle like this in quite some time, and it's very risky to do, but maybe they can pull it off. Maybe that's how they can penetrate through the defense of the Destruction Warlock, is just by going all out. Let's just try and get a kill. Who cares what it costs us? Try and catch them off guard, but so far the boys have not been caught off guard. Easy Money finally retreating away into a better defensive position. Burt gets caught, trying to blink back, looking for one Greater Pyro Blast, but without Varen casting at the same time, it's a lot less threatening. Chun-Li has his entire defensive lineup. This is looking solid for the boys to close. They've got a significant mana lead. What can Easy Money do here? Now caught into a Fear, Thugonomics pushes forward. Touch of Death available. Double Polymorph. Usually Polymorph is where we see the Greater Pyros be set up, but they're so far behind that they're just unable to. Finally, double Greater Pyro being cast. Chun-Li stalls both of them.
Oh, nice plays. Beautiful spear hand strike on Burt with the paralysis on Baron, able to shut down that play from Easy Money, who was looking to set up on a Karecki. That was really, really nicely done, and the boys consistently shutting this down. They definitely know the win condition of Easy Money. So far, they've been doing a great job to deny that. Baron taking some pressure. He gets interrupted. Interrupt on Burt as well. Both Greater Power Blast being stopped. Thugonomics now looking for some Chaos Bolts. Finds one on Burt. He uses Temporal Shield to deny a lot of that incoming damage. But still, Thugonomics casting out a lot of Chaos Bolts here as Easy Money is forced to retreat.
All right, Tuna, is he going to sit down for a drink and regenerate mana? It doesn't look like he's just jumping into the fight. Bashing up Thugonomics. Meteors connect, but Ironbark from Karecki easily stalls that push. Maybe not. Double Greater Pyros. One in the sky. Tonganawix tucks around the corner, takes the hit. Grecki recovers quite easily. Chun-Li looking like he wants to push forward, but Line is sighting Greater Pyroblast at the same time. Tactical push here from the team of the boys as Grecki jumps in, trying to initiate for the kill. Gets deflected with the Dragon's Breath, but then responded to by Thugonomics' Infernals. Dark Soul, big burst potential. If Thugonomics can get in line of sight of anybody here, he might use the Unending Resolve aggressively. Goes for the Mortal Coil, combos it into the Bolt. Huge hit onto Burt. No block for 2 seconds. Is he going to fall? 1 second. Ice Block available and manages to stay alive, but I'm going to chalk that up to a little bit of luck on the side of Easy Money.
Yeah, 1 second left before that Touch of Death was about to end Burt's World of Warcraft life. So definitely a little bit lucky there. Fortunate timing for that Ice Block. Grecki still making an offensive push, and Grecki's been constantly re-stealthing, finding these bashes, even gating in on top of Tuna to make sure he's playing aggressive and setting his team up. One Greater Power on Chun-Li. He's getting low, but with Burt having no Ice Block, he can safely use the Touch of Karma without the threat of that being removed and can redirect some of this damage. He's going to be feeling confident, pushing forward, still finding some good damage on Burt. Leg Sweep was traded out with the Storm, Earth, and Fire. What is Burt going to do? The beautiful Vortex by Grecki setting up Chun-Li, pulling Burt back after he blinks away. Once again, Ring of Peace denies a Greater Power Blast from Varen, and the boys really have been doing an excellent job with all the tools they have to shut down Easy Money. What is Easy Money going to do? Another Chaos Bolt lands onto Burt. He's looking to run away. Denies with the Dragon's Breath for a moment. Tuna has to keep him alive. Fist of Fury all over Burt. Chun-Li could be in some trouble as well, as Varen is counter-pressuring with his Combustion. But I think it's Burt that's ultimately on the back foot.
Yeah, Tuna crowd-controlled for some time. Thugonomics looks to close this out. Grecki secures the kill. The boys now put Easy Money on match point and look to close the bakery.
Burt gonna feel the hurt there too. They enter Ruins of Lordaeron.
And Enzi's gonna be substituted in as Tuna's gonna try and cook a tuna casserole instead. Closing down the bakery, trying to mix it up and bring in some diversity. This composition did allow them to beat the Banditos earlier on in the tournament, but it's not a super potent composition. In the past, it used to be strong at dismantling Destruction Warlocks, and I'm interested to see if it is still the case even after that Demon Armor addition to the class.
Yep, Easy Money. The spice was not nice, so they have to switch it up a little bit. Game number three with everything on the line for this team. The boys looking to clean sweep on Ruins of Lordaeron. Thugonomics going to be shut down. And typically, the Warrior with the Fire Mage is going to be good.
Oh, they're going after Grecki.
But it looks like they're actually going after Grecki, potentially trying to really punish that Feral Affinity. What is Grecki going to do? Honestly, out of all the druids I've seen in these tournaments, Grecki has done the best job at surviving, but a huge all-in onto Burt. Gladiator's Mallet completely absorbs that Cauterize.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.